Let me talk to you corporate constructs or you legal fictions that keep asking why become a secured party creditor, sui juris, or to be just a man, to be in proper status. Now, first and foremost, because right now you are a corporation. You are a corporation. You are in a corporation is a thing. A corporation cannot think. I'm not insulting anyone. I'm just telling you how a corporation appears on paper. Because a corporation could only exist on paper. In reality, it has no substance. So a corporation does not think. A corporation does not act. A corporation is a thing. The short terminology of it is a corpse. And as you all know, a corpse is dead. A straw man is dead. It is a thing. It is a thing. So someone must control it or act for it or do things for it. And I emphasize the word it. It is a thing. It is a legal fiction. So right now, in your ward of the state status, you are a corpse. You are a dead thing. This is why it is important to become a secured party. Things are dead, not alive. Corpse, again, is a short version of corporation. It does not think. So, corporation shall be deemed to include any company, trust, or so-called trust, or association incorporated or unincorporated with or what is actually is organized to carry out or to carry on business for its own profit or that of its members. That's what a corporation is, and from the legal standpoint. So, where are you going with this, Tazen Doc? Well, you give me a minute and I'll show you why I'm going with this. I'll show you why I'm going this with this. So what you need to do is redeem yourself. This is why many of us refer to it as the redemption process or becoming a secured party creditor. Now, did you know that the United States actually defines, excuse me, the fictitious entities spells like, you know, spell with all capital letters or all uppercase letters as corporations? See, if you doubt it, matter of fact, some of you will doubt it, so don't believe me, go and check it out for yourself. The definition is in 15 USCA, United States Codes Annotated, Section 44. So don't believe me, go and check it out. Go and check it out for yourself, but I'm going to quote it here. Corporation shall be deemed to include any company, trust, so-called Massachusetts Trust, or association incorporated or unincorporated, which is organized to carry out or to carry on business for its own profit or its members. End of quote. That is a corporation. That is a corporation. So if the state has actually created this unincorporated corporation, by way of your mom informing on you through the live record of birth and them creating a birth certificate, then does it have authority over it? It, the corporation, the thing that you think you are. Yes, it does. And until you give them notice, otherwise, they will always have authority over it, the corporation, which you think you are. This is why the redemption process is necessary. This is why become a secured party creditor. So that is what one of the things that a UCC-1 financial statement does, which is essentially part of becoming a secured party creditor. So it gives public notice, and what essentially it's occurring when you become a secured party creditor, you are given public notice that you, the secured party, have a claim against the debtor. Against the debtor. You're no longer the debtor. You are the creditor. The unincorporated corporation. So now when you file this notice of a secured party creditor, you take this entity out of the state, out of the jurisdiction of a fictitious entity into a private venue. Do you understand? Do you overstand? Do you understand? See, you, in your kingdom, and thus the entity becomes foreign to the state, and now it becomes unincorporated foreign corporation to the state. I know. It sounds like an oxymoron, but then again, I'm using their terminology. So please, please, please bear with me. Now, the financial statement. What is it, Tazada? Well, it's a document setting out a secured party security entrance and goods. This is what's essentially listed on the financial statement. It's a document designed to notify third parties, generally these prospective buyers or lenders, that there may be an enforceable security entrance in the property of the debtor. So it is merely evidence of the creation of a security entrance, and usually is not itself a security agreement. So the financial statement is filed by the security holder, which becomes you, once we teach you how to become a secured party with the Secretary of State or a similar public body, and it becomes part of a public record. See, you're not asking for permission for anything, because a man does not ask anyone for permission, because I've taught you, according to Genesis 1 and 26, man is sovereign in his proper status. Man does not ask for permission. Man does not ask the courts for permission. Man does not ask the state for permission. Why? Because all of these things were created by man, and they're all subservient to man once you learn how to become a man again.